Excellency, Honorable Prime Minister of St. Lucia, Dr. Philippe Pierre, Honorable Ministers here present, the representatives of international organizations, the Secretary General of the CARICOM, Governor of Lagos State of Nigeria, members of the legislature, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I stand on existing protocols. All of us from Africa and the Caribbean, at this moment, that at any other time in history, hold a firm conviction that determined action and not chance or handouts from elsewhere can grant us the economic emancipation and the dignity we deserve as a people. We gather here in the land of many waters, buoyed by that conviction, to re-energize and reinvigorate the movement we collectively started a year ago. It is therefore my privilege and honor to welcome you all to the second edition of the Afro-Caribbean Trade and Investment Forum, organized under the auspices of His Excellency President Irfan Ali and his government. I'm singularly honored to express our gratitude to all the heads of state, for their who sent representatives, prime ministers who are here, and all the senior officials who have joined us this opening ceremony. Your presence here today is a strong vote of confidence for the project of achieving stronger Afro-Caribbean trade and investment relations. We have clarity on why we have embarked on this journey. I outlined it during the first edition in Barbados last year, when I said, and I quote, "Today, we are gathered here to course reverse, to turn the atrocity committed over 400 years ago into an asset for our people. We hope that when we leave here, our two regions will have forged an unbreakable, everlasting bond that opens direct links, enabling the Caribbean to receive a fair share of tourism receipts from African tourists. We want to live here actionable proposals on how to open air and sea links between the Caribbean and Africa. We would like to live here with concrete plans to open banking and payment rails, seal joint ventures for industrial projects, deepen commercial collaboration in the creative and cultural space, including how to collectively protect our intellectual properties, and create institutional arrangements that will enable capacity building and greater daily engagements amongst ourselves. We want to live here clear in our minds regarding ways to catalyze manufacturing investments in the Caribbean to take advantage of the $27 trillion